Hey folks, it's old Gary Navarre, Grandpa Gary G in the UP here. I'm gonna trim a vase I made here. Got a skinny neck on it. I got lucky and I soaked this bisque trimming jig here. What do you call them? I forget it. Anyway, I soaked it in water. And then I set it on center here, pretty close. Then I stuck the pot in center, I hoped, level or close. And guess what? He's so beat. Can't really beat it very much, can I? So now, what did I do with all my tools? Oh, I moved everything over a little bit. There we go. See how far off I am. There we go. There's one way, and then there's another way. That's pretty far to look down there to see. Oh, I see it. Yeah. Just kind of line it up down there with the wheel. Anyway, there's that high spot. Now, how do you do that? About like that. Let's hope that works. And I'm not going to do much right there. Just want to put a little bit of a foot on it, I hope. I'm hoping I don't have to wad this up. I might. I don't know. I don't really want to do a heck of a lot to it. No, so far I don't need to. Now what? Boy, I think I'm liking this porcelain and stuff. There, that's good. That's enough of that blowing in the wind. Smooth it a little, maybe compact it, I don't know. It was pretty stiff. Leave fingerprint spins on there, marks or whatever. I don't really want to mess with that too much, do I? Maybe get some of them trim marks out of there. Well, make sure there's a little bit of pitch. A little bit of pitch here. Don't want it sitting on the inside edge or wobbling. There, get the widest part of the base. We'll do it with that. It feels balanced. It feels well. I haven't messed this one up too much. This porcelain stuff, boy, it'll leave a mark real quick you touch it. It'll just show everything, alright. Of course, you know. That's the difference between real handmade and machine and crafted for machine production. You know, it's two different fields of study. One of a kind or all the same. I gotta think of each one what I'm gonna do to it because I don't make them all the same because I just never got the trained. I made the same with maglite. Not that that's an ad for them, but I used to work on them. turn them black and send them back there in Kalamazoo. We had an anodizing factory. This looks okay to me now. Let's see. Yeah, I think that'll do. Alright. I think that one I'm gonna let dry. I'll set that over there. Can I get another one? See if we can pull that off too, eh? Guess I'm getting a little overboard there. Let's try that again. There we go. New mark. Oh, right in front of me. Okay. Come on, you. Darn close. No. No. There, that's kind of better. Well, this is coming along pretty good. I'm fairly close as far as the year is concerned to what my business plan was. I didn't expect to get rich this year. I just wanted to do two shows. I entered an exhibit. Special invitation. Well, I didn't expect that. It was nice. And then sold a few Christmas wreaths. Haven't sold any pots yet, but I've been lazy. I'm too busy making things. Been lazy and didn't put any postings, but Oh, that's all right. They'll always... I'll be around. I'm not going anywhere. You know. I might make somewhere else, but... You know. I'm not starving. I'm not having a starving artist sale. Sorry. Sorry, you ain't getting the Walmart price. I was kind of hoping my bosses at Walmart would have done something with the high end, but they didn't do nothing yet that I know of. Heck, the economy, what it was, it turned into, it was barely able for them to keep going. I think it was good in a way, but for them, a little bit of pitch, a little bit of a swirl. Yeah, that's good enough, just about. I might be getting better at my throwing, I don't know. I wish I could make them all the same, but I guess that's not for me. It's okay. You're not going to give me an E just because I can't throw them all the same. We won't get into why Bill Pitney gave me an E. But, I guess I learned my lesson. There, I like that kind of. Just real simple, see? Yeah, that's good. Okay, that's enough of that. See what we got. I'm gonna set that one over here. The reason I don't do the same thing over and over is because I can't sit there that long. I gotta get up and move around or my back will just mess up. And I won't feel good anymore. When I don't feel good, I don't want to work. Definitely. You know what I'm talking about. If you don't feel good, you don't want to work. There, that's good. Put that one away. All right, well, I guess we'll...